Hello guys, welcome back to Tesca Technologies Private Limited, and my name is Shivam Vijay, and today in this video I am going to giving a demo on electropneumatic trainer with PLC control. In this video we will be seeing about the basic electropneumatic components, how the electropneumatic components work wired according to the PLC program. Some later examples for controlling the process we will also see in this video. So what is PLC? PLC, or we can say programmable logic controller, it is basically a programmed controller to control the operations of any of the desired machinery or any of the desired industry. PLCs was invented in 1968, and after that to suit a basic electromechanical circuit in which the electromagnetic relays are used, they were replaced by a basic programmed integrated circuit. This is used eventually, and nowadays PLCs has an important role in all type of industries, in all type of processes for complete working in the industrial process. So PLCs basically works on the integrated circuit designs so that it is more compact than the heavy mechanical or electrical wired panels. So it consumes less space in the industry or in the panel. So the machine cost and the machine space and machine size are also compressed through using the PLCs. Although the most complex calculation and the process can be done using the programming section, so that all the program are stored in the small memory chip inside the PLC, and you can perform all the complex to complex situation and complex to complex operation using the PLC. So using of PLC creates the industry environment very easier to perform. Diagnosis of the fault condition are easy using with the PLC. So we'll perform some examples of PLC working. We'll do some ladder programming also, and then we'll perform some examples with this electropneumatic components to give up a PLC explanation with the electropneumatic components. So now let us move on to all the component details. I will give you a brief description about the different parts of PLC and how we are going to control this. We will also see in this video. So this is our complete trainer, the electropneumatic trainer, PLC based. The order code is 52107A. You can use this order code to find out all the specification about this trainer, what you can get from this and what you can learn from this trainer by visiting our website, which is www.tescaglobal.com. Now I will explain you all the parts one by one. So we'll start with the very first part, which is the FRL unit. This is the filter, regulator and lubricator unit. So when inlet line or the incoming line from the air supply is connected at this point, this works on the specified direction. Direction is mentioned on the upper side of this FRL unit so that you can connect the 8mm PU tube with the inlet line over here, outlet from the pressure, so it can be connected to the other components. Then the FRL unit, it is called because it filters the air supply from the moisture content which is required and present in the compressed air. And also regulator is provided for regulating the pressure of the supply. This is the knob over here. If you move this in the anti-clockwise direction, this will decrease the pressure, and if you move this in clockwise direction, this will increase the pressure. Pressure can be observed on the pressure gauge provided on the front. And then there is some lubricating oil is also filled up inside, so some lubrication is also provided for working all the components which are mechanically based. Then output of the FRL unit will connected with the slide wall and the manifold or junction box. The junction box and the slide wall is required. This has an inlet of 8mm PU tube also. So when you connect the 8mm PU tube over here, this is starts supplied inside the air. This is the slide wall. If you move this in this direction, this will continuously give air to the further supplies. These are three junction points of this supply. At here you can take the supply output to connect it to any of the component in your complete trainer circuit. This design, as you connect the any PU tube of 4mm size, then it will start giving the air, otherwise it is blocked from the inside. So this is a design to provide the junction and all the supplies can be connected from this. Then output from the manifold or the junction box can be connected to the 5 by 2 solenoid control valve, or it can be connected with the 3 by 2 spring return type of solenoid control valve. These both valves are used to operate the cylinders. We'll discuss them later, but first we'll discuss about the 5 by 2 solenoid valve. This is the 5 by 2 solenoid valve. It is called as there are total 5 ports. 1 and 2 are the output ports. Then there are 3 ports over here. 1 is the pressure line input port and 2 are the exhaust port over here. So there are total 5 ports, and out of them 2 are using for controlling the action. So that's why it is called 5 by 2 solenoid operated valve. Solenoid operated valve is called as because it works on the solenoid. This is a electrically controlled coil. The coil, when the supply is provided to the coil, the magnetism form and there is a plunger inside the valve that will pull when the coil is energized. So when the plunger is pulled, ports will be opened according to the design of the valve, so that we can create the air supply pressure to the desired location. So what happens in the 5 by 2 handover operated valve? Pressure line is connected over here, will energize the plunger and coil. The plunger will pull, the pressure line will open in the first condition to the fourth number port over here, so that connected line from this will be provide giving the pressure, and at the same time the output line is connected with the two number port, and pressure outcome or from the outgoing pressure will be exhausted with the exhaust valve. And the other case, when this coil is energized, the vice versa process will happen. Pressure line will connect with the two port and exhaust line will connect it with the fourth number port. So that's how the 5 by 2 solenoid valve works. In case for checking, there are some mechanical plungers are also provided. If you press them, this will show you the operation without electrically energize the coil. Similarly, we also have 3 by 2 actions solenoid valve, in which total 3 valves are provided. 2 are of the working then, and 1 is of the exhaust valve over here. So 3 are from the working, 2 are the use valve over here, so that's why it is called 3 by 2 solenoid valve. Same working of the solenoid will also happen, but when we remove the supply, this is a spring return type of solenoid valve, so it will again pull back the plunger to the original position when it is not energized. Then we have some flow control valve. The flow control valves are used to control the flow. So as we control the flow of air supply, then we can also control the pressure of the cylinder, and although thus we can control the speed of the movement from the cylinder. So as we control the flow, as the flow is decreased, the speed is decreased of the cylinder, and if the flow of the air is increased, the speed and pressure of the cylinder is increased. So that's why we can achieve the speed control using the flow control valve. Then we move to the single acting cylinder. This is a single acting cylinder having the 50 mm of stroke over here, and this works is a spring return type single acting cylinder. So we can provide the air supply to this location only, and when the air supply is going inside, this push the piston forward and we can achieve the forward movement from the single acting cylinder. And when the supply is removed, the spring return force will close the outlet with the 3 by 2 solenoid valve, and air supply is removed. The inside air filled will again exhaust from this, and this is a outlet open over here, and spring is connected with the piston rod, which pull backs the piston rod to the original position in the retracted end. Then we have a double acting cylinder over here. The double acting cylinder works when we provide the air supply from the rear end. This will start filling the pressure inside the cylinder, and piston will push to the forward direction, and when we provide the pressure to the front end, it will start filling the pressure out in the front of the piston and starts retracting the position of this cylinder. So we can achieve the reverse movement from that, and at the same time the air filled inside the from the back will be exhausted from the back one, and when we work with the forward movement, the air filled from the front side will exhausted from the front end as well. Then we are using some magnetic switches over here, so it senses the position of piston beneath the magnetic sensor, and as the sensor senses the magnetism created, and this is a NPN type of magnetic sensor, so it energizes with the 24 volt power supply, and when the piston beneath the sensor is present, it senses and gives the output on the third wire. There are three wire terminals. I will explain it while working with this. Then we move on to the push button and control block. So this is a basic push button control block. Three type of NO push button are provided, and one is the selector type push button. So it will change the position only in two direction, and these are the momentary push button. Just need to push this and again it retracted to their original position. These are the connection lines of this push button. Elements are provided for joining the light. You can connect the push button to over here, and these are the NO and NC terminals of this all the push button. So we'll use them and study about them while working with the practicals. Now we move on to the PLC description. So this is our PLC block over here. The programmable logic controller is based on two important parts: the central processing unit and input and output of interface system. So these are the input of this complete PLC, and these are the outputs terminal of this PLC. These are connected to this terminals provided on the front panel. So PLC has from 1 to around 12 inputs. You can provide the 12 different inputs from the complete section line, and there are 8 outputs of this PLC that can be used to perform the operation. So PLC senses the inputs and give the output according to the logic design inside the memory of your central processing. This will process the complete processing with the central processing unit over here. Then we have the internally connected, the central processing units govern all the PLC activities, and it comprises of the three parts, which are the processor, memory system and the power supply. So this can be powered with the 24 volt power supply. We will connect this on this terminals, and after powering on, we will see working of the PLC with programming. Then we have switch mode power supply, which is a 24 volt SMPS working at 4 ampere DC supply. So it works on the 220 volt AC power supply source. The on off button is provided. So it requires to control the supply, the complete functions and systems like the PLC and the other coils of the solenoid works on the 24 volt power supply. So we require this power supply to be performing all the experiments on this trainer. Then for the accessories, we are providing some PU tubes for making your connections. There is about half a meter of 8 mm of PU tube, and rest of about 15 meters is about of 4 mm PU tubes, some stoppers and some tools for connecting and adjusting all the sensors and all the components. And this is a cutter is also provided for cutting the PU tube in your desired size to performing the experiment. Some patch cords for connecting the signals through the PLC for operations, and the user manual is also provided. This box contains the most of the information about the trainer. You can study it in detail for working with this, and you can get the knowledge of complete PLC working, then the component working, and how you can program the different logics. I will now describe you some of the basic program, software installation of this PLC ladder program, and then we do some basic sample examples on given in this exercise book also. After opening your setup file, you just need to double click on this setup file and then press yes. It will start installing the software. And here this is the welcome window for the version 8.1. press OK over here, and this will start installing the all process for Logosoft Comfort. Accept the license terms, press next. This is the directory
which is auto created. So press next over here, and this you just need to press to select where you want to create the production icons and press install. This will completely install your Logosoft Comfort for programming software, in which you can do your ladder programming for the PLC. We will see some example as well for the ladder program. USB cable driver will also required for this, so press OK or yes for installing that, because it's required to communicate the PLC with PC, and then you will ready to use the software. The installation process take about 5 to 7 minutes, or if your PC is slightly slower, that it will take about 10 minutes or more than 10 minutes. So depending on the PC performance, software installation will done. So here our software has completely installed. As I press done, it will launch the Logosoft Comfort version 8.1. This is the help section. Close this. This is the online support. And this is our main software window. From here we can start working.
So after opening the program or the software, this window will be shown, and here we have to first connect the PLC with the PC. For that we can go to tools option over here, and there is a determine logo option. So this option is required when you want to automatically determine the PLC connected with the PC. But if you want to select the PLC with your own choice, you can select the hardware over here, and here you can select the different PLC input outputs and all the communication and hardwares or the settings. And this is the type of hardware. There are a lot of type of hardware that is supported with this software for programming, so you can select any of them and starts working. Then use the same hardware that you have selected and program PLC accordingly. Now we will first determine the PLC over here automatically, as we have provided a PLC which is a specified hardware for us. For that we just need to know the IP address of that PLC. So we'll move to the PLC and see the IP address. Then we change our IP address of a PC in the same series, and we are ready to communicate the PLC for that. So we now move to PLC and panel settings. Now firstly we have to power on the SMPS, connect the patch cores to powering on the PLC as well. For this use two patch cores, connect them to the sockets provided on the SMPS supply, and this will be connected to the 24 volt and zero terminal over here. So supply to the PLC will be provided when we power on the SMPS. SMPS is already connected to 230 volt AC power supply with the patch cord provided with this, and now we'll turn on this. And as the SMPS on, power supply of the PLC is also on. Now we move to the front screen of the PLC and see the IP address inside it. So when PLC got turned on, now we can press escape over here. These are the different parameters and setups in the PLC. So we'll go to network menu, press OK. Here we can see the IP address, which is 192.168.0.003. So we need to make same series of IP address, subnet marks and gateway in the PC for communicating the PLC with our setup. So this is stop and run indications of this PLC. It is now in the run mode. Press escape again, and this will show you the time or the date. You can set this with the setting inside. And now we'll move on to again from PC, and over here we'll connect a LAN cable on the slot provided on the lower side of this PLC, and I will show you how to connect the LAN cable also. Now for connecting the LAN cable, over here there is a slot. You can connect the LAN cable, Ethernet type of LAN cable on this PLC like this. The other end of this LAN cable is already connected to the PC, and here you can see as I connected the LAN, it starts blinking and showing me the notification for LAN is connected.
Now, after connecting the LAN cable, both end, one end to the PC and other end to the PLC. Now, we are ready to configure the IP address as per the series of PLC. So, for this, we go to control panel, open the network and sharing center and change adapter settings. Here, if you right click, go to properties and go to Internet Protocol version 4, TCP IPv4. So we need to change the IP address over here. This is now at the automatically obtaining IP address settings. For this, we'll change this, use the following IP address and give the IP address as 192.168.0.1. As the PLC IP is 0.3, so we have make the same series and 0.1 that we have selected for the PC. The last digit of the IP address should be different, but the complete series till the first three points need to be same for communicating. Now, subnet marks should be 255, 255 and 255. Default gateway also as per the PLC, which is 192.168.0.15, and press OK and again press OK from here. So now PLC communications has been set up. Now we again open the software and find the PLC. Now after connecting PLC and PCs, just using the LAN cable, just press the tools here after opening the software window and press determine logo over here. Then you press the start logo icon on the tools bar, and as you press the start logo icon here, you will find the accessible logo is 192.168.0.3. If you don't find any of the PLCs in this block, just press refresh like this. It will connecting to BM and it will find the all connected logo PLCs for this. And if you want to connect and work on this, so the target IP address here you can select like this, and this will stored in this, and press test over here, and test is successful over here and it will start flashing the PLC. So this is how you communicate the PLC. Now PLC is connected with the PC right now and we are ready to do the program. So logo is already in run mode as it find when we connect this, and if you want to stop the logo PLC, just press the stop logo icon over here. So this will stop the logo. Press OK. So logo will be stopped from here. Now this is the basic programming window. We are ready to do programming for the PLC over here. Now if you want to do the programming in function block diagram of the programming method, you can use the same method and same screen over here. But if you want to do programming in the ladder logic functions, just go over here this like icon and this will show you convert to ladder. Press this and the icons and menu options will be converted as per the ladder logics. So we are now ready to perform the ladder program over here in this circuit diagram too. So I will explain you some basic of the components for the ladder programming that you can use in the ladder programming. Now I will explain you some basic components of programming. This is the diagram and circuit section over here. The circuit diagrams are given. This is symbol of ladder diagram. In this complete project, we have created the ladder diagram in the ladder circuit diagram 2, and the circuit diagram 1 is for the function block diagram. Here you can use functions like this input and output and the different processor function. So this is the different programming mode. We are working on the ladder. For this, we will first do a simple program. I will explain you all the parts which are required to control So this is the first one, which is make contact. So make contact is basically contact over here. So when you use, you need to provide and define the input for this, whatever the input you want to use for this make contact over here. So I am selecting input 1 for this, and it is shown that this is working on the input 1. So when the PLC senses input 1, this will be on the high condition. Now similarly, there is also a break contact. So break contacts works, or the NC, we can see it and say it NC contact. You have to select another input for that as well, and this is the NC contact over here. This will gives you the output, which is in non-momentary option. So when you, this is in already high condition right now, and when the PLC senses any input on the input number 2, this will goes low inside the logic. So that's how logic performs. So NC condition will remain NC until it gets the electrical signal, and NO condition will remain the NO until it gets the electrical signal. And when the electrical signal or the input is provided to any of the input selected for these signals, this will change the reverse action. NO goes to NC and NC goes to NO. Then we'll talk about the relay coil. This is the relay output coil. So whatever the output you want to create, you can use the output relay coil. This will actuate the output on the PLC when it is high. So this is connected on the output side. This one is all the input side for the PLC, and this is, and the ladder, the output will connected when any of the two input or any of the input is high. This will connected with the output and output goes high. Similarly, there are some other instructions which are inverted output in the NC condition, analog output when you working with the analog PLC. The PLC that we are using is basic PLC. It does not support the analog input output, so we cannot work over here, but software provides you all the facilities for working with the different programs. Then we have special timer on delay, off delay, on off delay, retentive delay. There are different types of timers. You can use them according to the programming sections. These are the different working. All the details of working are also provided in the help section of this software. And then we have counters as well. The counters works with the probable countings, and on the countings you can do different programmings as well. And there are some more AND, EDGE or different type of instructions to use. So we'll do some basic instruction programming for the electronumatic trainer. So now we'll first make a basic program for describing the AND logic in the pneumatic trainer with the PLC. So for that we will use the make contact. This is the first make contact input 1 will be defined, it select it on the ladder side, and again we select a make contact. This will give you, we will give this input 2 as a definition. So these are the two make contacts which are now at the low condition. So we will use now a relay coil, which is the output for this, and output 1 Q1 is already defined. We can create and define the available blocks output for different values. Memory blocks, memory flag, which is right now you can see, these are also provided. So this will also use, will describe the use of this as well. And this is how you can create a AND logic. This is a basic AND logic. Now use the ladders to be connected, and this is our AND logic is created. Now what happens when both the inputs are high, the output will be high only in the single condition. If any of the input is high, the output will not high. So this is how AND logics works. The AND logics are also verified with this. So this is the basic program that we have created. Now we can download this in the PLC first and then operate it on the Lumatic trainer. Now for downloading the created program, the program has been complete. Now just press the PC to logo, or you can go to tools, transfer PC to logo. The program need to go PC from logo. So we press the PC to logo over here. This will comes to interface. Select the PLC that you want to select over here, and test is complete. Now press OK. The device is in run mode. It's
prompting you the device it is in run mode. First you have to change the device in desktop mode, then it will download and again it will move the PLC to run mode. So we'll press yes, stop mode is going on and device is stop mode. If you want to change this the run into run mode, press yes, otherwise press no, the device will remain in the stop mode. So we'll press yes, we require the device in the run mode. So our program has been downloaded in the PLC. Now we will execute the program on the pneumatic trainer.
Now for after installing the software and developing the program or the ladder logic in the software, now we are ready to perform it on the main trainer board. So first we have to start the compressor. We'll need to connect firstly on the FRL unit. So we'll connect it to the FRL unit over here. This is the input section of this, and output from the FRL unit will be going to connect on the manifold over here. So we will use the 8mm PU tube for this. Connect it like this. This is our the PU fitting. Just need to push it down and you will get the output or the connection done. If you want to remove this, just pull the blue section on the downwards and you will get to release the all PU fittings easily. Now we'll connect this to the manifold section over here, and this section and these connections will be remain same for all the exercises that we are going to do on this trainer. So now I will turn on the pump and we'll get the pressure in the pressure gauge, then we'll regulate the pressure with the regulator and adjust it to the desired value. So here I have turned on the pressure or the wall of the pressure outlet. Here pressure you can see it is about 5 to 6 bar, so we need to decrease it. Turn this to the anti-clockwise direction and pressure will start decreasing. Pressure around 3 to 4 bar will be enough to operating our components. This will work from the 2 bar of the minimum pressure to the up to 10 bar of the pressure. Do not exceed the pressure about the 80% of the capacity of your components. So we'll use the pressure in between 2 to 8 bar. Now we will set up the connections for the solenoid coil over here. For this we will first operate the single acting cylinder with the AND logic that we have created in the PLC. So AND PLC right now. For this first we will do the pneumatic connections. So we'll connect the output from the junction box using the 4mm PU tubes. Any output we can select, and now we'll provide it to the input of this 3x2 spring return solenoid valve, and the other end of this output port will be connected to the input end of the single acting cylinder. Now we'll do the electrical connections for the same. So as we have created the electrical connections for the input and output, as that D1 and D2 or I1 and I2 that we have used for the input output segment. So we'll connect the input output as per the circuit diagram. Now for making the electrical connections of this AND logic circuit that we have downloaded in our PLC, we'll first have to extend the 24 volt power supply to the push button block. So we'll use patch cords to extend the power supply to the push button block. 24 volt power supply is required as we are going to do the connection. Now we'll provide a 24 volt supply through a nano push button, and the output of the push button will be connected to the DI1 over here. Then similarly another input will also required for the AND logic, which is input 2 that we have defined in the program already. This will going to the input 2. These are the two inputs that we have connected. Now the output is going from the output 1. So the solenoid valve that we are going to use is the 3x2 solenoid valve. So the wires or the coil wires or coil cable of the solenoid valve will be connected on the output terminal. So we'll provide ground from here, and 24 volt will be have to provided on this, which is coming from the PLC output. So this is the DO1 over here. So we'll connect this to the DO1. So this is how the electrical programming or electrical circuitry have to be mentioned. Very less wires are required for performing this logic. If we are going to perform this logic with the original pneumatic diagram and with the conventional electrical circuit, there might be some relays and other components required, but from the PLC we just need some of the wires and our programming has been done. Now for execution, we'll also create the simulation for this, and we'll also do the roundabout program for this. Here you can see input 1 and input 2 are provided from these two push buttons. So this is right now at the zero condition, that I have not provided any of the supply to any of the input. So both the inputs are right now low, so there is no output on the cylinder. And if I provide input 1 as a high and input 2 is low right now, there is still no output on the cylinder. And if I press the input 2 and input 1 remains the low, there is no output on the cylinder. This is the truth table of the AND gate that we are going to verify. And now if I press both the inputs, the output will occur and cylinder moves forward. And if I remove any of them, the cylinder will retracted, as the conditions of the truth table of AND gate will not satisfy for output. So this is how we perform the AND gate operation. Now for the basic learning, we'll also see it on the simulation as well, and also then we create the OR gate program for the basic understanding.
Now once you've done your program and experiment, you can save your design program. So just press save over here. Samples, you can select the desired location over any of the PLC location. So we'll select the desktop, create a new folder over here and describe this. Naming as logo programs, and you can give the name also, file name, the AND logic that we have created, and save this. So your program has been saved as AND logic. So you can anytime recover this program. Just open the file and AND logic is saved in the desktop. Now after downloading the program, and when you are going to execute the program, for watching the simulation in the ladder logic as well, we just need to turn on the online mode over here, online test. Turn it on. This will ask you to select the PLC, what PLC you are seeing want to online. Test it, press OK. Here you can see the bus bar is right now red, and when I press input 1, this will go red and continuous output will be going on. And when we press input 2, this will also go red and the high output will be provided to the coil and we get the output on. So as simulation, if I am pressing input 1, you can observe the so input 2 is going high, input 1 is going high and continuous the supply line to the input 2, and when I press input 2, output goes high in the at the AND logic is satisfied. So that's how AND logic and the input outputs work with the simulation. Now similarly, we will perform a OR logic program also for the basic information. In this, use the input 1 for the first input. Again we'll use another input as an input. We'll select this over here and a relay coil which is connected to the both output. So output 1 is at the relay coil. Now we'll make the ladder like this, connect this directly over here, and for the OR logic we just need this at the lower ladder line so that we can create a ladder like this. So we need to connect this to this branch over here, so that whenever the both any of the input is high, the output goes high. So right click on the blue icon over here. And straighten this like this. So here you can achieve the OR logic program for this. And after creating the OR logic, you can download it to your PLC similar manner. We have to acquire for this test and press OK. Press yes, data is transferring. Press yes again and PLC is in run mode. So that's how the OR logic is done. Now we'll see the practical working on the OR logic with the pneumatic trainer.
Now, as we have created OR logic in the programming and the OR logic is downloaded in the PLC, at the same time we does not require to change the connection. This is the advantage of PLC. We just need to do modification in the program as well. Do not need to change the connection because we have just provided input 1 from the push button 1, input 2 from the push button 2, and output remains the same that we have defined in the PLC. So just the logic has been now changed and we will now perform the OR logic on this setup. So in the OR logic, when I press any of the input, when both the inputs are low, the output will be low. So when any of the input will be high, the output will be high. So if I press input 1, output is high. If I press input 1, 2, output will be high, and if I press both the input, the output remains high. So this is how we verify the truth table of OR gate for this section as well. There is no changes in the connection. The connection remains same for the AND logic and OR logic. Just need to change the communication and the logic inside the PLC program.
Now we'll also observe the simulation of the OR logic as well. For this, same the process for simulation online and press OK. And here if I press input 1, output will be high. If I press input 2, output will be high. And if I press both the input, output remains high. And when both the inputs low, output goes low. So that's how simulation is also visible on this computer screen. Similarly, we can create the project for this also. Save this in your PC in the new folder. Logo programs, sorry, that we have created, and provide name or logic for the PLC purpose. So our program has been saved now. Similarly, we can perform all the different basic programmings. Now we'll move to the exercise programs given in the user manual, then we perform all the operations on the electro-pneumatic trainer. Now for the first exercise of the PLC ladder logic diagram of single acting cylinder, in which we perform A plus and A minus operation, we are now going to make the ladder logic for that. For this, we will first select a make contact over here. You can also provide the block name, input 1 as we have given here. So we can comment the name for that. We'll comment it start push button PB for the short, and put this on the line. And for the second one, we again select a make contact and we'll give input 2 for that. And for comment, sorry, we'll give input 2 for that. And for giving a comment or a name, for understanding, we will give it A0 magnetic sensor, which is present on the left end or rear end of the single acting cylinder. Now we'll use a brake contact and we'll give it input 3, assign the name in comment A1 magnetic sensor which is the front end sensor of the single acting cylinder, and here we'll use the relay coil in the output and give it name Q1, and in comment we'll give it S1 solenoid. As the name. Also, for holding the circuit and creating the new cycle, we'll again select a make contact and place it over here. Give it the block Q1 that we have used in the relay coil, and now we'll join them together and create the ladder logic as described. Now here we have to connect this on the middle of I2 and I3, and now for adjusting it, just pull it like this, selecting the cursor tool, and this is how your ladder is created. So what happens over here, when the PLC get input on the first input PB, the I2 magnetic sensor, which is A0 magnetic sensor, which is already at the, when the cylinder piston is already at the back position, this will already high in the output because it's sensing the piston just beneath it, and both the lines will be completed and we'll get the output on the solenoid coil. Because this is already high, because this is the brake contact, so as it not sensing right at the first position, it will not high on the screen or on the PLC, so that all the three inputs will be high and we'll get the output at the same. So when the output will be high, this will also high, and when the input PB will released and magnetic sensor also disconnect or dissense when the piston moves forward, this will make the high or the complete line to be operated the coil. And the same time when the piston moves forward and reaches the forward position, this will energize the sensor I3, and as the sensor gives input to the input 3, this brake contact will go low, as we are using the brake contact over here. So as it is go low, this will cut the complete supply to the solenoid solenoid S1, and this will remove the supply from the coil as well. This will also goes off and the cylinder will retract as the supply from the coil will removed. So this is how our logic going to work. Now we'll see it on the practical explanation and practical execution of the electro-pneumatic trainer. Here, after creating it and realizing the logic as described in the user manual, now we are ready to download this program in the PLC. For this, just press the PC2 logo icon over here, select PLC, test it and press OK. This will start downloading the program in the PLC and your PLC goes in the run mode. Also, you can now see the complete execution with the PLC output while working the complete output input connections with the electrical circuitry, and your operation will be performed.
Now for the first exercise, the connection for the single acting cylinder operating the pneumatic connection will be remains the same. Just need to change some electrical connections. So we'll again build up all the electrical connections as we defined the input output in the program. For this, the extension of the 24 volt is already provided. We just need to add some connections for this as described in the program. So firstly, we will provide start PB 24 volt input to be provided on the PLC. So we'll use a 24 volt using the push button, and this will provide at the input number 1. Then the A0 magnetic sensor need to be provided on the input number 2. So this is the wire of A0 magnetic sensor. The A0 magnetic sensor is the backside one over here that we have providing. So these are the three wires of this A0 magnetic sensor. The brown and blue wire are for the power supply and black one is for the output. So we required to provide output of the sensor as an input to the PLC. So we'll provide power for the sensor first. For this we'll connect it to the 0 volt and 24 volt. Here you can see on the sensor, as the sensor is sensing the piston position just behind it and it's light up giving the signal that the sensor is now energized. So we'll provide it to the, sorry, this one is connected on the DI5 wrongly, so we'll connect it to the DI2 as the input 2 that we have defined in the sensor. And now we will use the I3 magnetic sensor, which is the A1 magnetic sensor, at the I3 input. So A1 magnetic sensor is similarly, we'll use the wiring of A1 magnetic sensor as well. So we'll provide power supply to this also. You can provide power supply from these terminals as well. These are already internally connected, so you can provide the power supply for the removing the bulkiness of the connections and easily visible all the connections. So output will be going to the input 3 over here, and solenoid coil of the three by two solenoid valve will be connected at the DI1 similarly as per the AND and OR logic. So we'll connect it to the DO1. This is the output of solenoid coil 1. Now our connections has been done. We can verify it with the circuit diagram or as per the input output that we have defined. Now we'll start performing an execution of this. So after verifying the connection properly with the program, now we can perform the single cycle operation of single acting cylinder. It will goes forward and return backs with the magnetic sensor's input. So we'll press push button one time. Here you can see it goes forward and comes back from the reverse using the magnetic sensor output. It will be visible to you when both the magnetic sensor senses the piston, the lights up. Let us take a closer look of this. Here you can see when I press the button over here, this will provide input to the input 1. Already the logic is defined that when the cylinder is at the back position, so it defines that when the sensor is activated, this is defining that the cylinder is at the back position. Right now lights up and giving the input to the PLC. So first line of the ladder will be goes high and solenoid coil will be operated, and as the piston reaches to the sensor A0, this will goes high and cut the input to the solenoid coil, and that's how it's again retract back. Here you can see if I press input once, this go forward and comes reverse. Here slight blink of the sensor is also achieved, that is showing that the sensor is sensing the piston and giving input to the PLC.
And for simulation, we again go to online for testing it. Here you can see start PB is not pressed and A0 magnetic sensor is already sensing the piston position just beneath it, and it is high already. So when input is pressed, the line goes high, and the I3 magnetic sensor that we have used the brake contact already, so this is not high right now, but in the NC case it is already high. When it starts sensing the piston, it goes off. So the line will completed and solenoid valve will be on, and this will start completely to the cycle from the bus when input is released, or magnetic sensor will also dissensed. So we'll do the setup for the simulation. Here you can see as the start PB comes, sensor is already sensed, and I3 sensor when goes off when cylinder reaches at the front end. So that's how you can observe the complete working at the simulation also. And after completing the execution, as we have completed, so right now we can save the program, or you can save the program earlier as well whenever you complete the program for the execution. After execution, it is confirmed that the program is completely working, so there is no additions are required. So we can save this program in the logo program software over here, and this is the ladder logic for single acting cylinder SSE A plus and A minus. This is the cycle that we have created. Now save this, and your program has been saved to memory or the location in storage of PSE. Now we are going to open the multi-cycle operation program which is already created for your ease, and open the file folder, and here you will find the multi-cycle operation of SAC A plus A minus, and open this program. Here will be new circuit is added in the circuit diagrams also and on the screen as well. This is the complete program of multi-cycle operation, similar given in the user manual. Now you can download this program to your PLC and start performing the execution. Download this in the same way. Downloading procedure will be same for all the programs, and here you can ready to do performing the operation. After downloading, you will be observed that how to perform the program on the real time.
So now, as we have created and downloaded the multi-cycle operation of single acting cylinder program in the PLC, so the pneumatic connection will remain same. Just we can add the flow control valve for understanding the flow controlling in the multi-cycle. Just close the slides wall over here and use a PU tube to extend the connections from here. This will now connect it through a flow control valve like this, and carefully and properly insert the tube so that there will be no leakages. Now we can control the flow and speed of the cylinder as well using this flow control valve. Now we'll do the electrical connections of the same. For this, as defined in the program, we'll use this all the connections. So firstly, we have to provide the input at input 1, which is the start push button for this. So we'll use a push button connecting it to a 24 volt power supply. Output will be provided to of this push button, so the 24 volt will be provided to the DI1. Now as the input 2, we required a stop push button. For this, the stop push button is provided over here. This is the NC contact, so this will be remains constantly on and off. For this, we'll use this input 3. We have to connect it at the NC position, that the NC terminals are defined in the program. So when we press this button, this will goes to NC condition, NC will goes to NO, and our program will execute it. Now for the further connection, output from the 24 volt will go to input 2 over here. Then we have to connect the A0 sensor. For this, the A0 limit switch or the magnetic switch will be used. So A0 is the back one, backward end limit switch. So we'll provide power supply to it first, and output will be connected at the input 3. Similarly, the A1 limit switch or the magnetic switch will be connected to the input 4. When sensed, it gives the output at the input 4. Now the solenoid valve will be connected with the ground connected to the 0 volt, and output will be connected with the DO1 over here. Now our connections has been done. Verify these connections as per the program we have created and done. And now we are ready to perform the experiment. For performing it, we just first press the push button over here, and then when we first and just provide the input signal to the PLC, the multi-cycle operation will start going on. Here you can see the speed is decreased as we have controlled the flow of this. So here you can see the speed of the cylinder can be also controlled with this flow control valve. So if I open the flow of air using this flow control valve, you can see the speed of this multi-cycle operation is increased. As the flow of air is increased, pressure generation is also increased, and here we can increase the complete speed of this double acting cylinder. Now if I close the flow control valve again, the speeds again starts to decrease. So that's how we can control the speed of the any of the pneumatic component with the flow control valve using in line with them. Now to stop the execution of this multi-cycle operation, you just remove the stop button and your multi-cycle operation will be stopped.
Now for observing the simulation of the multi-cycle operation, I will also explain you what happening right now. So when we first we will go to online, test it, and right now all the bus bars are right now high. Over here you can see the stop push button that I have already pressed. It is giving the signal at the input 2 from the NC, as we have used the push button in NC condition. And as I press this push button, it will again goes high because it is NC and NC is on right now. So when we press the start push button, input 1 will get high, and A0 limit switch, which is already sensed with the piston position at the backwards of the cylinder, it is already high. So this complete line will go high and will get the memory coil 1 got high. When the memory coil 1 got high, and the complete line will hold up with this. So when we release the push button, this does not affect this line because it is already in on condition through the M1 coil. Now move to the last logic over here. When the M1 coil goes high, here the M2 coil or the memory coil M2 will in the off position right now, because the cylinder does not reach up to I4 or A1 limit switch. So this is remains in the off condition because the memory coil 2 is already off. So this will NC that we have used over here, the brake contact, so the line will be goes high when the M1 coil will high. So this will operate the solenoid coil Q1 over here. Now when the cylinder reaches the forward length, extreme forward position, the I4 will be sensed and give input to the PLC. At the same time, the A0, that is when the piston is moved from the A0 limit switch, this will desense the value, and the output from the limit switch will also goes off. So that's the NC that we have used will be high because the input is off at the I3 position. Then the stop push button is continuously on, so it is giving the NC over here, and memory coil 2 will goes on. So this will hold this cycle as well when the I4 limit switch is sensed. But when we again, when the memory coil 2 goes on, this will disconnect this line when the M1 goes high. This Q2, that the brake contact or NC contact that we have used over here, this will goes off and cut the line of this solenoid coil, so that the solenoid coil will goes off. And as the solenoid coil goes off, spring return force pull the piston back and I4 again got distanced. And similarly, this memory coil is holded already, and again when the piston reaches to I3, it will starts the memory coil 1 again, and again and again continuous cycle will start in this manner. Simulation will also provided when I provide push button on. Here you can see at this simulation, just memory coil 1 is continuously on through the push button, and input sensor will changes the position. When the input sensor 3 is reached again, it will cut the line and memory coil 2 goes off. At the same time, memory coil 2 of the NC will goes high and this block on the solenoid coil again. Similar position will achieved again and again. That's how we can achieve the simulation on the ladder logic as well. Now we will create the ladder logics for double acting cylinder. Same response will be happen, A plus and A minus. Forward and reverse action will be happen with this ladder logic. So we are now going to create that. For this, you just need to add new program or add new diagram on the circuit. Here new diagram is added, convert it to ladder, close the original circuit diagram 3. Here we can create the new program for single acting cylinder. Input 1 is required and provide the name or comment to it. Start push button, select it over here, then we again use a make contact. Input 2 will be assigned to it and we'll create a new name, A0 magnetic sensor. For this there are some miss operations. Start PB is input 1 and input 2 has the comment A0 magnetic sensor. And now we'll use the relay coil for the output of solenoid coil 1. As we are using the double solenoid coil wall, for this there are two solenoid coil, so we'll give the comment it. This is the S1 solenoid coil. Now create the ladders using the lines. Now again select I3 input, give it a comment on name, the A1 magnetic sensor. And here we have to just use a relay coil as described in the user manual. So this will operate the solenoid coil 2. So S2 solenoid coil, that we are going to give the name to it. Now again create the ladder. Here what happens when the start PB pressed, the I2 magnetic sensor is already in the on condition as the piston just beneath it and solenoid coil 1 will be on. And as the forward movement happen, the solenoid coil 1 will be off as I2 will removed, or I2 is de-energized when the piston moves forward, and when it reaches at the forward end, I3 will be goes high and it will high the solenoid coil 2. So at the same time, when the solenoid coil 2 goes high, the retracting movement or the reverse movement of the cylinder will start.
So now we have created the double acting cylinder program in the ladder logic, and we are now ready to do the pneumatic connections for that. The basic pneumatic connection that I have explained will be remain same. Now we are going to build up the pneumatic connection for the double solenoid coil and double solenoid 5x2 solenoid wall. For this, we'll use a PU tube from the junction box over here and connect it to the pressure port or the P port or the input port of this double acting cylinder. Similarly, output from this will be connected. The A port will going to the flow control valve in between, and from the flow control valve will connect the rear end of this double acting cylinder and at the other end, the output of this flow control valve will again connected with the the output of direction control valve will connected to the flow control valve, and then output of this flow control valve will connected with the front end of this double acting cylinder. So these are the pneumatic connections that we have done over here. Now we'll do the electrical connections for this. Now for the electrical connection, we have to just provide start PB for the input. So we'll provide 24 volt to any of the NO push button. Output from the push button will connect it to the DI1. And now for the input 2, the input will be provided from the magnetic sensors. So we'll connect the A0 magnetic sensor from the cylinder, and this will connected in similar manner as we have connected in the double acting cylinder. So positive negative of the sensor will be connected and output will be provided on the DI2. You can also observe that the sensor has been light up because the position of the piston is at the just beneath the sensor. So it is sensing the position of piston and giving input to this. Now we'll use the input 2 or the sensor 2 or A1 sensor for providing the input as the input 3 for operating the coil 2. Similar manner, we'll connect positive and negative to the 24 volt power supply and output will be connected at DI3. So this is the input section that we have connected and performed. Now we'll do the solenoid coil wiring. For this, the S1 solenoid coil, the left one solenoid coil will be connected to the output 1. Ground will be connected to ground. This will go to output 1, and the right one solenoid coil will be connected to the output 2. So this is the basic connections of the as per program. Verify them as according to the program, and now we are ready to execute this with the single cycle of double acting cylinder. Now for executing this, we just turn on the slide valve over here and press the PB once. Here you can see the cylinder moves forward but nose goes retracted. This is just because the fault finding is easier. The sensor does not sense the front position of this. So we'll adjust this sensor, and as the sensor senses the position here, you can see as I adjusted the sensor slightly, the sensor sense the position that the cylinder or piston moves the forward limit, and it gives input to the PLC and cylinder retracted. Now we again test this. Here both the sensor has set at the good position, and our cycles of one cycle of front and backward movement is operated with this input. So that's how the fault finding is also easy. Just when we look up to the ladder, we find that the in the process control the interlocking with the sensors are failed. Just need to check the sensor whether the sensor is operating or not, as we done in this, and as the sensor operated, complete working is going on.
Now let us see the simulation of this one as well. Go to online. Here I2 magnetic sensor, as the input I2 A0 magnetic sensor is already sensed right now, and when I press the start PB, this will high up the line, and coil Q1, the left solenoid coil, will light up and energize, and this will start the forward movement. And when the cylinder reaches to the I3 position or the A1 magnetic sensor, this will sense and light up, and again Q2 will be energized for that. And when the cylinder moves from the A0 magnetic sensor, this goes de-energized. So as the Q1 also got de-energized. So similar case, one cycle can be operated with this. So for simulation, we'll just press the push button. You can get both the coils energizing and de-energizing in that. So that's how our operation of single double acting cylinder one cycle is completed. Now you can save this again, press save button over here and create a name DAC A plus A minus, this is the cycle name and sequence of the cycle. Save this over here and your program has been saved in the location. Now we move to the next program. Now we'll see the multi-cycle operation of DAC. For this, open the file folder. The multi-cycle operation of double acting cylinder is given over here. As the program is already made, just need to download in the PC and in the PLC, and we are ready to perform the execution of multi-cycle operation of double acting cylinder. So we'll download this to the PLC and we are ready to perform the operation of multi-cycle operation of double acting cylinder with this ladder logic diagram. And now for the last operation, which is the multi-cycle operation, the program that we have already created, downloaded in the PLC, and now we are going to do the same for the electrical wiring. Pneumatic connections and pneumatic wiring will remain the same for this as the multi-cycle operation, and we are now going to perform the electrical connections for this. For this, we just need to provide the input push button at the input 1 first, as described in the program. So input 1 is provided to the DI1. Now we'll provide the stop PB as we provided in the multi-cycle operation of single acting cylinder. For this, input from the NC cycle is provided. And this will connected to the I2. Now push button section is completed. Now we'll do the sensor wiring. For this, sensor A0 first will be connected to the input 3 as we defined. Just need to connect the input and output as defined in the program. So provide power supply to the A0 sensor. Here you can see sensor is light up, and now we'll provide input to this input 3. A0 sensor is connected at input 3. Now we'll use the A1 sensor. For this, again provide the supply to it and connect the output at the DI4 input. So 4 inputs has been provided. Now we have to provide the outputs. For outputs, this is the solenoid coil 1, the left one. So we'll first provide the power supply to solenoid coil 1 with the digital output 1 over here, and for the solenoid coil 2, we'll provide it to the DO2. Ground will be connected with the ground and DO2 will provide it. So here now we have ready to perform the experiment. Just verify the connection of all the inputs and outputs as per the program definitions and program defining, and now you can execute your program. So now we are ready to execute our program. For this, just press the stop PB providing the continuous input, and now one time we'll press the start PB and continuous cycle and multiple cycle will on for this. So this is how multiple cycle operation is performed and achieved. Here we can also control the flow
for controlling the speed of both the direction. Use the flow control valve for controlling the speed. Here you can see we have control the speed. You can increase and decrease the speed of movement with the flow controlling of both the sections. If I remove the supply and increase the supply from one side, you can see the forward movement is fast but reverse movement is slightly slower, and if we increase the air supply to both the ends, here the speed of both the section will be higher. And when you just want to stop the complete operation cycle, just remove the selector push button from that and your continuous cycle will be got stopped.
And now for the simulation of this operation as well, we'll go to online, test it and press OK. Here online bus bar is now on. Over here you can see the stop PV is right now not pressed. So if I press the stop PV, this will light up, and as I press the start PV, input 1 will high and continuous line supply will be provided to the memory coil 1. Memory coil 1 will hold the complete cycle and also operates the other cycle. A0 sensor is already sensed that we have used over here, so this will operate the Q1 coil. And when the forward movement happens and piston reaches to A1 magnetic sensor, I4 will goes high and this will operate the solenoid coil Q2. And at the same time the I3 sensor is disconnected, as the sensing of this sensor will not happen due to the forward movement of the cylinder. This will turn off the Q1 again, and as the Q2 ons, this will again move the piston backwards and again I3 starts sensing the sensor and again Q1 will on. So that's how continuous cycle will be going on and off with this till the M1 coil will be in the on condition. For cutting off this holding of M1 coil, just need to release the P push button. So we'll start the cycle and you can observe both the cycles simultaneously turning on and off, both the inputs and outputs going on and off. And when we remove the supply from the stop PV, this will disconnect the M1 coil and that's how both the operation will be stopped. So that's how we can observe the complete cycle with the simulation as well, and this will help us to rectifying the fault and diagnosing the complete process as per the simulating properly or not.
So here our demonstration of this electro-pneumatic trainer based on PLC is now completed. In this video we have seen that how we can create the program ladder logic with the PLC and download them in the PLC software installation, as I've already explained in this video. Also we have incorporated some basic logics for operating some of the electro-pneumatic components provided on this complete trainer. You can do your experiments as I described in this video, or all the exercises that I have covered in this video. And for detailed study about the components, about the PLC and other features of this complete trainer, you can use the user manual. There are details in the complete explanation are given. You follow them and still you find difficulties while working with this kit, you can contact to Tesca Technologies Private Limited for all type of supports. And if you like this video and if you find this video useful and get some knowledge about the PLC electro-pneumatic components and how the PLCs are now incorporated with the industrial uses, please like the video. If your concepts are clear about the PLC and ladder logics and about the electro-pneumatic components as well, And you can also share this video to your friends, to your colleagues, to your classmates, those who want to learn about the electronumatic components, PLC basics, PLC ladder logics. There are some basic information that will be very useful for them and that can incorporate in the industrial purpose, and their training will be very fruitful with this video. You can subscribe our channel. There are a lot of videos with the practical hands-on information with different type of educational trainer kits are uploaded, so you can watch them and clear your concept for different types of topics as well. And don't forget to press the bell button, so whenever we upload our new video, you will get the notification about that as well. And thank you for watching this video, and we'll meet in the next video very soon.